everybody. It's Sunday morning of the first week of me getting back to training and starting to train for actually running my first marathon as opposed to completing my first marathon. And I'll be trying to do that next spring. So yesterday I did a quick little speed session, which was okay. But a little bit disappointed in the overall pace. But you know, that's the whole point in doing these things, is that you know that you're not very fast. And I know that I've lost all my speed, so I'm not very fast. So it would be quite perverse to expect me to do my first speed session and expect to be a Speedy Gonzales. So today it's Falkland Trail Runners, and it'll be a longer run, and the weather is pretty poor. It's pretty cool, it's pretty wet, pretty miserable, not my favourite running conditions. But hey, it's a run. You know, we're going to be doing this second attempt at preparing for a marathon over the winter. So, you know, doing it in the summer was my preferred method. I, you know, much prefer running in the warm and dry. But determined to do this, actually running a marathon while I'm 60. So that means I have to have it done in the springtime. And that in turn means that I need to do my proper training over the winter. So that will be interesting. I do quite enjoy running in the winter, particularly when it's dry, but the idea of running when it's cold and wet, that really doesn't hold any attraction for me. But I know I'm going to have to do it, and will my perception change once I get used to doing it? I don't know.
We'll be right back. of the world.
I ain't afraid of no one.
Well, I have to say that was quite good fun. Hard to believe you're saying that would be good fun. Yeah, I guess people's perception of wading up to your main bits in cold, freezing cold water would hardly be described as fun, but there's some kind of perverse pleasure in getting cold. In actual fact, it's you don't feel the cold. Once you're through the first part, it doesn't matter anymore. And just seeing everybody kind of behaving like big kids, you know, if we're honest, was really just very good. Anyway, in terms of what we actually did, it was just under 7.5 kilometres, so about 4.5 miles, something like that. Pace wasn't, well, I don't think you could have really achieved a reasonable pace in these conditions. It was a struggle just to get through the mud and water in places. But yeah, it certainly didn't do any harm. Okay, so that's the first 2 days back at actually trying to get back into shape, and yeah, enjoyed both sessions. So that's the pre-week, let's say. So the week's run from Monday through to Sunday. So week one of the preparation for spring 2016 starts tomorrow. The forecast is for rain, but we will go out. My plan is to try and do something most days. I don't think I can really commit to doing something every day, and it's probably not good to do something every day when you're just starting to build up again. So we need to be building up pace and hills while still trying to extend the distance that I'm doing. I think if I can do these three things, then we should be well on the way to be able to actually run my first marathon in the spring and come in at that sub 4 hours time that I really want to make. Good, so there we are. So hope you found that interesting, and we'll see you next time.